With Excel's SUMIF function, we can quickly add numbers in a range that meet a single condition. Like if we wanted to find out the total sales revenue from employees on the North team on this list. Let's type an equal sign, the function name, and open parenthesis. We can see that there are three possible arguments. Two are required, and the argument in square brackets is optional. So our range will be where we want to look to find our condition. That's the team values, column B. We type a comma, and our criteria is next. We want Excel to look for the word North. Since this is a text value, we enclose our criteria in double quotes. We type the word, double quotes, and it doesn't matter whether we type this in lowercase, uppercase, or sentence case. Excel is just looking for the letters. After this argument comes the third argument, sum range. That is, where exactly will Excel find the numbers that you want it to add? It's here, in the gross sales column. Remember to close parentheses and hit enter. We expand our column width, and now we have the sales figure for the North team. There is another way to do this, especially if we wanted to summarize the sales data for all four teams. Let's type the team names here on the side. And let's delete the formula we typed in just now. Our steps are the same at first. Equals, function name, and open parenthesis. We select the range, and we know that whatever we do here will pretty much be copied to the other three rows, so we'll want the range to stay the same. Excel gives us the ability to lock the reference or range that we've just typed by pressing F4 right after we've typed it. Mac users, you press Command T. We see the dollar signs before the column name and row number. This means that these are absolute references. For our next step, we type a comma to get to the criteria, which this time will not be explicit text, but rather a cell reference. Excel will look for whatever value is typed in this cell, E4. So we don't type double quotes here, since we're not looking for the letter E and the number 4. And we won't make this an absolute reference either, because this reference will change for the formula below. We type our comma, and of course our sum range is exactly what we had before. But again, we'll want to make this range absolute, so F4 or Command T. Close parentheses. So we've got the same value here, and now we can copy to the other rows, and we have our totals. Let's do a quick check to see if this is correct. We want to look for all the North values. This is one, and we press Control to select the other one. Mac users, you can press Command instead of Control, and in the lower right corner of your work area, you'll see the sum of these two values. It matches the value calculated by our SUMIF formula. Let's do the same for the East team. 1, 2, 3, we're holding the Command or Control key, and this total matches the total that we got from our SUMIF formula, so we're good. Here's a twist. Can the SUMIF function report on values that are not equal to a given criteria? Yes, it can. Let's do a formula to find out the total sales generated by all teams except the North team. So we want to add gross sales where column B is not equal to the word North. We quickly get to entering the arguments. We type our parentheses and function name. Let's get our range here and type a comma. We will type double quotes because we are looking for values. But the logical symbol for not equal to is the less than, greater than symbols together. We type the word North and double quotes. So we're saying to Excel, look in this range for text that's not equal to the word North. We type our comma and of course our sum range. We close parentheses and hit enter. And we just added all the sales that were not made by the North team. Remember that we mentioned that the last argument in this function was optional? Well, let's take a look at an example of using only two arguments in this function. Here we have 8 days worth of banking transactions, and we want to find out the total withdrawals during this period. Withdrawals would be negative dollar amounts, so less than zero. Let's get started here. Our range will be the amount column, column C. And after the comma, we know that we want Excel to look for cells where the values are less than zero. So how do we represent that? We realize that this is a logical test. We want less than zero, double quotes. And in this case, we don't need a sum range. When we emit the sum range argument, Excel will sum the values in our range, which meet the criteria. So obviously, this only works if the cells in our range are numerical values. We close parentheses, enter, and expand our column, and our withdrawals for this period are displayed. We can also use the SUMIF function with wildcards to do partial searches. Like this. What if we want the total value of all e-transfers for this period? Well, an asterisk in an Excel function can represent any number or string of characters. It's like a placeholder. So once we enter the basics, we know that our range will be this column, and our criteria will be enclosed in double quotes because we're looking for text. We enter an asterisk to represent any number of characters before the word e-transfer. And we also type an asterisk after to take care of any characters which may come after that word. We make sure we close our double quotes, type a comma, and then our sum range will be column C, the amount column. Once we're done entering our arguments, we close parentheses, and now we know the value of all the e-transfers of this period. The SUMIF function is very valuable as we can use this to make lengthy reports more meaningful by summarizing information that's important to us. Want to learn more Excel tips? Subscribe to our channel or visit GoSkills.com.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.